Hey, what's going on, guys? It's me, Aiden, from Cartoon Apocalypse, and today I'm going to be talking about Vaporeon and basically just explaining what his power is, how it works, and what episode I think he will be appearing for the first time in. Now, for the first time is in quotation marks because we've already seen Vaporeon, but since Party Crasher was played out of order, I'm going to be talking about the episode that he should have first appeared in if the episodes were played in order. So, yeah, if you look forward to this video, please leave a like and subscribe for more content similar to this. I also have Monkey King and Pegasus explained videos, so if you want to know more about, you know, Monkey King and Pegasus, you can go check out those links down in the description below. And this is the very final day of the hashtag Miraculous Video Every Single Day Challenge for the week. So, you know, if you haven't been caught up on all those videos I posted last week, go ahead and check those videos out. But without any further ado, let's go ahead and talk about Vaporeon, because we saw him in Party Crasher, but since Party Crasher's main idea was to introduce Monkey King, we didn't exactly see too much about Vaporeon, but we did actually see his powers, so we can actually kind of talk about what, like, he did. Also, I guess I should mention, in case you didn't know, Vaporeon is Luca. That's been a pretty well-known fact for a while now, but in case you didn't know, Vaporeon is Luca. So, in Party Crasher, we saw that Luca set a point in time. So before they started fighting Party Crasher, Vaporeon said Second Chance, which is what his power name is called. So he said Second Chance, and that pretty much just created like a waypoint at that specific point in time. So then when they went to fight and Carapace got, you know, captured by Party Crasher, he was able to go back to that waypoint that he previously set because that's what his power is. So basically he has the power to go back in time to any point that he has set. So this is a little bit different from Bunnyx. Bunnyx can go through time forward or backward, and she basically creates a portal and goes back. Vaporeon's power is more of just reverting things back to a saved point. So it's like if you have like a video game that you saved a level in and then you died, so then you had to go back to the previous save. That's exactly what Second Chance is. Now, Vaporeon does not lose any of his memory after that Second Chance, so it's pretty much basically just like a video game as far as like, oh, you knew what you messed up on, so you know not to make that same mistake again. So that's basically what Vaporeon can do, but all of everyone else doesn't retain their memory. They lose their memory, so Vaporeon is the only one that saw what happened previously, so then he can help fix the problem that they ran into. So Vaporeon activates his power by sliding his fingers on his little bracelet thing, and it's just a cool little snake thing, and that's our guess as to what his Miraculous is. Now, his Miraculous weapon is actually a harp or a lyre, so it is a kind of musical instrument. It hasn't been confirmed, like, if it's a harp or a lyre, but it basically is one of those things. Now, we don't know, like, what he can do with it. He can throw it, but we don't know if it has any other special attributes, like if he plays it, something happens, and it's not actually required for like activating the Miraculous. Like, Rena Rouge has a flute, but she has to play that in order to create an illusion. But for the lyre, Vaporeon doesn't have to use it, so I'm wondering if he has some sort of power with it, because I mean, a harp is a pretty bad weapon in my opinion. Like, sure, you can like hit people with it and throw it and stuff, but I mean, there are definitely some better weapons. So I'm wondering, like, if he can shoot something with it or play some music and something happens, because I mean, just having a lyre would be a pretty bad weapon, I think. So let's go ahead and talk about what episode I think that he will first appear in, because there are only a couple episodes that it could be, because I'm almost 100% positive that Star Train is going to be the episode that we see Pegasus for the first time. And that really only leaves a couple other episodes that we haven't seen in between the production order of Party Crasher and all the previous episodes from what we haven't seen before. So let's just go ahead and talk about all the episodes that he could technically be in, as far as like what the episodes that we haven't seen yet that happened, or at least that were produced before Party Crasher was produced. So that could be Ikari Gozen, Feast, Kwame Buster, Star Train, or Desperada. Those are the only episodes that we haven't seen that were produced before Party Crasher. Now, I'm pretty sure we can just knock out Ikari Gozen, because that has something to do with Kagami, and we know that Kagami will be getting the Dragon Miraculous, and we will be seeing her this season based off of that photo that Jeremy Zag put out there. So I'm pretty sure that's when we'll be seeing Kagami's Miraculous revealed. And then, just like I said earlier, Star Train will most likely be the episode that Pegasus is released in. So, that leaves Desperada, Kwame Buster, and Feast. Now, Feast is an episode where Master Fu takes Marinette and Adrian's Miraculous in order to protect them, and if you know me and you've seen some of my videos, that is the episode that I think the swap will happen, because there is a Miraculous swap, I think, this season, so I'm pretty sure that's the episode that we will be seeing that happen. So that leaves Desperada and Kwame Buster. Now, there's really a 50-50 on this one, because Desperada's synopsis is Ladybug and her team face Desperada, an akumatized guitarist, rock and roll day plan for our heroes. And then Kwame Buster's synopsis is Ladybug and Cat Noir confront Mr. Mendivali, now Kwame Buster. Now, if you want my personal opinion, I think that there's a higher chance that he will first appear in Desperada, simply because it says Ladybug and her team, first of all, that's the first hint, and second of all, this episode is based around like a music type of episode, and as we know, Luca plays the guitar, and he just likes music, so it makes sense for him to be in a music-themed episode, and really just the Ladybug and her team part, you know, really sells it to me, but again, there's not really any way to tell, because it could be Kwame Buster, and Ladybug and her team could be referring to Carapace and Reina Rouge, so I don't exactly know what to expect, but pretty much my guess is he will be first appearing in Desperada. So there we have it. I'm pretty sure I talked about everything we know about Vaperion. Yeah, pretty cool stuff if you ask me. Vaperion's like a pretty popular person, I think, as far as like people just really like Luca and he gets a Miraculous, whoa. So I'm pretty sure Desperada is going to be like a good episode that people are interested in. And honestly, I'm pretty sure most of the episodes that we have remaining this season are going to be like pretty intense episodes as far as like plot filledness, because I mean, there's not really much left. We're over halfway through the season, but there's like three new Miraculous holders, so that's at least three new episodes with plot stuff in it, and then just a whole bunch of other stuff is going to happen, so it's going to be a very interesting rest of the season, and I'm really excited to see, you know, what's going on with that. But yeah, that's going to be it for me. If you enjoyed, you can leave a like and subscribe for more content similar to this, because as you know, I do post content fairly often, so go ahead and subscribe if you're not already, and yeah, so that's going to be it for me, and I'll talk to you guys in the next video. Goodbye. Je me réfugiais quelques heures ici en attendant que la frénésie de maquillage de ma fille soit passée.